The Kepler Space Telescope discovered something very strange, and there are suspicions that it could be a sign of alien intelligence.
Scientists aren't saying it's aliens, but come on, it's totally aliens. Hey everyone, Trace here for DNews with astronomer Aaron White from the California Academy of Sciences. Hi, Aaron.
Hi, Trace. How are you?
I'm good. I'm just excited about aliens. You've probably heard this week about a super weird discovery from the Kepler Space Telescope. There might be aliens around a distant star, KIC 8462852, or at least that's how it's being reported.
Yeah, there's a lot of excitement around this story, but we've got to keep ourselves grounded. Essentially, the Kepler Space Telescope has a specific mission. We're looking for planets around distant stars. Kepler has spotted something unusual, and that has been blown up by the media to huge proportions. We're not saying it's aliens, but maybe aliens.
Let me reiterate, astronomers are not saying it's aliens. They're just not ruling out aliens as a possibility, right?
So Kepler's mission is to look for transiting planets around other stars.
We've talked about these on DNews before. Kepler looks at a star, and if a planet passes between the star and our point of view, we'd see a dimming light. So think about it this way. Normal starlight, then the planet starts passing, slightly dim, more dim, slightly brighter, back to normal because the planet's moved away. That's predictable, it's regular, and it's easy to spot a planet that way.
Right, exactly. That's called a transit. It's an easy way to detect planets around other stars. Now just keep in mind, a normal run-of-the-mill giant planet like Jupiter, which, by the way, is about 122 times larger than the Earth, will only dim a star by about 1% when we see this transit. The crazy thing about this story is that KIC 8462852 is showing dips in the ballpark of 20%. That is insane.
So this could mean, right, Aaron, that something huge is blocking the star's light. Over on Test Tube Plus, Dr. Ian O'Neill, astrophysicist, and I talked about how a sufficiently advanced civilization might build a Dyson sphere around a sun.
We're talking about Dyson spheres. Come on, Dyson spheres.
That's so cool.
So a Dyson sphere is essentially a huge collection of space-based solar panels that gathers up light from its host star, and it converts it into usable energy. Any civilization that could build one of these things would give them access to an enormous power source. But as a side effect, it would block the star's light from a distant viewer's perspective, like maybe us.
So a Dyson sphere might explain the observations of KIC whatever. If your goal was to show other civilizations of your existence, putting a beacon, like a big artificial thing around your star, would definitely do it.
So what we're seeing could be explained by alien intelligence looking to make its presence known to other intelligent beings. But to be honest, it could also be a lot of other things.
Party pooper.
But that's why astronomers have always got to be careful about making any claims about aliens. Remember, aliens or not, this is still a pretty unprecedented finding. The real reason that we're even at this point of mentioning aliens is that so far the explanations for this huge dimming have come up pretty short.
Good old KIC 84, whatever, it's an F3 type star. It's on its main sequence. Basically, this means that the star isn't too old, it isn't too young, it's a little hotter than our star, which tells us that any dust clouds left over from its formation or particles blown off to the end of the star's life are unlikely sources for this dimming we're seeing.
Absolutely. KIC, whatever, also rotates slightly faster than once per Earth day. This is way faster than the observed dips that we're seeing, meaning star spots, which are sunspots, but just on a star over there, on this star's surface cannot be responsible. One of the remaining guesses is that some sort of collision within the system left a debris cloud.
It could be asteroids impacting each other. It could be planets colliding. But even that doesn't fully explain this dimming factor. Normally, dust from collisions would heat up and then glow with infrared light, which we would then be able to detect using ground-based follow-up surveys. And they did not detect any IR. Aliens, Aaron, say yes.
Still unlikely. I'm sorry. Instead, the best explanation is actually comets.
Comets?
Yeah, comets. So it turns out that if comets are in a distant orbit around the star and they were recently perturbed and knocked into the system, they could have bashed together, they would leave an obscuring debris cloud that could explain what we're seeing. Comets are in wide orbits, so any debris would move in and out of our line of sight. So it's possible that when they did these follow-up surveys looking for the IR emissions, they could have just missed that debris cloud and therefore wouldn't have seen the infrared left behind.
This is actually the most likely scientific solution that's been offered so far, but it would have to be a pretty incredible coincidence that out of the billions of years the star has yet to live, this event happened in the 4-year time span that Kepler was looking at it. Seriously, the odds are literally astronomical.
Astronomical.
It's important to stress here that all this talk of Dyson spheres and aliens, it's a far-flung idea, AKA, as we sometimes say.
I hear that you have a saying.
Do you want to say it?
More research is needed.
Remember, 20 years ago, we just detected the first batch of exoplanets, like ever. Exoplanet research is still in its infancy. The most likely solution is that there's some natural phenomenon that we haven't observed or we haven't thought of yet, and that's what we're seeing. Look, astronomers are not saying it's aliens, and they're not saying it's not aliens. It's more like they're saying it's not aliens, but we don't know what it is.
Yeah, so here's the thing, is that finding life beyond Earth is probably the biggest and most profound discovery that science could make. So we need to be absolutely sure that we exhaust every other possible explanation before we make that claim that aliens are responsible. So, you know, whenever you ask an astronomer, is it aliens? They'll respond with, no, of course not. There's more plausible explanations. Don't even think about it. But there's always that little bit in the back of our minds that says, well, maybe.
What do you guys think about this discovery? Is the media blowing it out of proportion, or is this a conspiracy cover-up of X-Filean proportions? Luckily, scientists have explored the idea of what alien life might actually look like if we were to come across it. And Amy assuages those alien assumptions in this video here.
The arsenic became a building block for a new strain of cell. When this news came out, it was massively exciting for the astrobiology and space world, but the discovery was eventually debunked.
So thanks for watching, everybody. Make sure you subscribe so you get all of our videos. And Aaron, if they have follow-up questions about aliens, I hear they can find you on Twitter at Astro what?
Astro W-U-T.
Astro what? It's aliens, so right. Come on.
I mean, I can't say yes,
just
but
between you and me, aliens?
In my heart, I want it to be.
Yeah.